move the whole thing over like 3 feet. There you go. Not even on you. Hey, Dakota! Woo-hoo!
Oh, you went too fast, and now you're... What's that? Oh, no shit. Sneaky, sneaky. So if you had to do... If you had to do your shocks over again, would you do something different? Like the Bilstein... We put Bilstein 51s... 60s on it.
Yeah.
Would you do anything different?
If they made a remote bypass, external bypass.
Sure.
That's about it. I'd put the same ones on again.
So what are you looking for more out of these? More low speed, high speed, less?
Low speed. They actually end it really good on the high speed. They're really nice.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
Low speed, still a little bumpy.
Yeah. So you'd lessen it out?
I don't know.
You take some valving out of it?
Yeah.
Okay. How about rebound? I've always been impressed with them, but
yeah.
How do you feel about rebound?
Yeah, rebound's great.
It does rebound pretty good. And it's it's slower than a lot of shocks out there.
I like it. You can drop ledges and it doesn't bounce. It just like...
Right. It's very controlled. It's very predictable.
Gives you a lot more confidence going over curves.
That's right. And you know what else? Gives you more traction. Because your tires, your weight's staying on your tires more. It's not bouncing all over the damn place. This is a little ledgy is what this is.
That's a big line, buddy. Big line.
Yeah, Straight to me, straight to me, straight to me. Oh. Yeah. If you gotta drive a TJ, it might as well look like this. Hola, Thomas. Dude, yeah, if you bump that, you're gonna be good, but I would steer into it. Well, you are, but that's not a big deal. Actually, go ahead and turn that way. Go forward and turn that way.
What this thing actually needs,
what,
for an improvement, is RCVs.
Oh yeah, RCV axle shafts. Yeah.
That's really the first thing this thing needs. I mean, you could use a rebuttal, but RCVs.
Yeah, I think you got it. I should have panned out. I'm a horrible cameraman.
digging.
It's a big old ledge. You don't want to turn left into that.
Tell you what.
You really think you're something, don't you?
No. I'm amazed. I'm surprised at every single one. I'm like, bam, I made it up that one too.
It never.
Instinct tells me that it should not be going up.
It never gets old.
Especially worn out and good year into yours.
I don't know. I wonder what the gear ratio is on first gear between the 3.8, between the 4-speed and the 5-speed Jeep transmissions. You know what I'm saying?
What about the new 8-speed?
Absolutely. What's that going to be?
I think it's the same.
That's going to be a crawling mofo.
Yeah, I think they're all roughly the same, and they just added more gears in the middle.
Okay. If you know what the difference is, leave it in the comments below.
Yeah.
I got to think, though, they shortened up first gear in that 8-speed and the 5-speed for off-roading ability. This is me making excuses for my 3.8.
Ooh, that's a line.
Sometimes. That's a burly line here. Let me see if we can see this. Yeah, there it is. That's a TJ line.
It is. Huge. I'm gonna stay on that rock.
Which one?
I know exactly where I gotta go.
You just pointed at about 800 rocks.
That one.
I'm gonna videotape.
The big one.
The big one. Which rock?
The big rock.
The big rock.
Grab your tires really good, so come my way more.
Careful right there, you're about on your drive shaft. rough.
Screwing up our 10 mile an hour average here, buddy.
You're the fucking best
spotter. Oh, there's no substitute for driving skill, though. Thank you. right there. Now cut back that way. Yeah.